नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मनु सिंह फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेन यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. एंड इन दिस टुडे सेशन आई विल बी डीलिंग विद द सब्जेक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव लॉ. एंड अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट टुडे आई विल बी डीलिंग विद द टॉपिक रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ एंड द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव लॉ. सो इफ वी मेक डिमार्केशन ऑफ और इफ वी क्रिएट अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू, दैट व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू सब्जेक्ट. सो वी कैन से यू हैव टू ब्रांचेस, टू अप्रोचेस. We can consider, yeah, we can understand this concept in this language, that constitutional law is considered as a substantive law and administrative law can be considered as a procedural law. Under constitutional law, this particular law describe various organ of the government or define various organ of the government, whereas administrative law describe them in a motion. Under administrative law, what organ and what kind of structure they haven't defined. So all these structure, all these formulation set in motion, yeah, have been set in motion by the administrative law. So we can say structure of legislature, executive is the subject matter of the constitutional law, and function are the subject matter of administrative law. Both these subjects are closely connected to each other and form the platform for proper, responsive and accountability of the act to the government. So constitutional law is the core law which gives very life, we can say, blood to the administrative law. So anything which is derogatory to the words and spirit of the constitutional law is the ultra vires, or we can say void ab initio. And it must be noted that if we are really want to comprehend the constitutional law and internal administrative law, then we need to have a very strong understanding to understand these two concepts. So moving ahead, we'll be discussing next thing, that what is the relation and what is the rationale and what is the logic behind to develop this branch, administrative law branch. So in constitutional law, arbitrary action is limited by the norms of principle of administrative law of fairness, reasonableness, justness. So administrative law deals with the organization's powers, functions, duties of administrative authorities. Power, function, duties of the administrative authorities. On the other hand, constitutional law deals with the general principles relating to of these organs with the individuals. So the constitution describes various organ of the government at rest, while administrative law describes them in a motion. So it may be pointed out that constitutional law deals with the rights and administrative law focus on the of public needs. So it is necessary of time to draw a line between these two laws in order to define a territory of the functioning of the administrative law. So there are various reasons we can say, and the need of the growth of the administrative law with the passage of time, circumstances, the needs of the people and state are also changing. Therefore, the legislature makes the administrative law as a separate discipline. Administrative law controls the arbitrary action of the legislative authority, which is very essential for the protection of public rights and duties. So the role of government is also changing with the passage of time. In developing countries like India, the role of government is wider because it acts as a provider instead of facilitator, as a regulator. So today the expectations is not only to protect the peoples from external aggression and internal disturbance, is also make a care of citizens from wither wounds to the grave. So therefore the development of the growth of administrative law became a backbone of the modern political philosophy. Hence there is a great need to separate international law from the constitutional law. So the main reason behind the development of the growth of administrative law is a process, we can say, and law can be in a adequate and traditional type of courts, a lawmaking organ which are not able to give the performance which is required in the present time in the proper functioning and welfare of the functional government. So in modern times there are needs of technical nature of legislation, flexibility and quick action and quality performance of the government. So there's a basic we can say reason behind of the development of this particular branch. Thank you.